Welcome again, everybody, to U.S. military base Shannon. I guess a lot of you remember when this was territory that was under full Irish control, and when there was little enough by way of human rights abuse happening in these areas. Times have changed. I suppose, to steal a phrase from some of our perhaps corrupt or centrist parties, there are new realities. But killing is still killing. Human dignity should still be human dignity. The right to self-determination should still be the same as it always was. As Ed said, we can speculate about what our local airport here, what Shannon Airport is being used for, and the role that it's really playing in these so-called new realities. We can speculate about what sort of deals have been done with the Americans. But for the few minutes that I have here, what I wanted to do was to actually give you some facts, to just talk about what's really happening, what we know about what's going through the airport. So here are some of the facts as we've logged, as we've recorded them, as we've observed over the last couple of years. We have an average of 20 flights per week taking US troops through the airport on their way to war zones. Omni Air International are the carrier that take most of those. I haven't checked at the far end of the airport this morning, but perhaps, Ed, maybe you have, if there's one of their planes down there at the moment. There may well be. Another fact, we have 20, 30, sometimes 40 US Air Force or Navy planes very clearly identifiable as US military planes on the tarmac out there. There's one of them out there right now. Some of you, I hope, will have noticed as you were driving in, seeing a grey Hercules jet sitting on the tarmac out there. These are capable of carrying the Predator drones, the unmanned aerial vehicles that are being used in Afghanistan and Pakistan, the ones that were used supposedly in surveillance, but also capable of carrying bombs, and the ones that bombed the oil tankers that killed so many people, so many civilians in Afghanistan yesterday. What else have we got? We've logged known rendition planes at the airport. Planes like registrations like N54PA and 379P, so many of these are very familiar to us. We've spotted them, we've taken photographs of them, we've asked for them to be inspected. The typical response to requesting for them to be inspected and to insisting on them being respected is threats of arrest or perhaps arrest itself for those of us who are active and doing this sort of thing. In most cases, the requests to inspect are simply ignored. What else have we got? Weekly flights by a company called Murray Air. They're a subsidiary of National Airlines. These are carrying cargo to Bagram Air Base in Afghanistan. In fact, I checked this morning on the website flightaware.com. Any of you can look at that, and it tells me that MUA 872 is due in at 11:14 this morning. So in about, what time is it now? Yeah, in less than an hour, this plane that we are told are carrying cargo and provisions for the US forces in Afghanistan will be landing at the airport, will probably overnight spend 30 to 40 hours here and take off again tomorrow. I'd invite you to go over to the airport during a few minutes of the day. Ask some questions about what the cargoes of these planes are. Where are they going? Why are they here? And try to find out something more about this. See it for yourselves. What else have we got? A company called Kalita Air, an airline that was found to be covertly transporting laser-guided bunker busters, as they're called, through Prestwick a couple of years back. They used Shannon Airport. A couple of days before Christmas, I think it was the 22nd of December, one of their flights came through. Here we might go into the realms of speculation because we don't have any facts about their cargoes, but we have to ask, were they at the time when so much white phosphorus was being brought to the Israeli Defense Forces, were they on a mission to replenish supplies or not? We don't know. Something else we know, some other facts. There are two US officers of military rank stationed here at Shannon Airport. Maybe one of them is here today? Any of you? Either of you? No? Nobody? Nobody putting their hand up? No.
It's a plugging device.
In any case, in a reply to a parliamentary question from Janice Sullivan, TD, the Minister for Foreign Affairs told us that these two officers are based in Shannon because, and I quote, they are engaged in assisting with the transit of US government or government contracted flights carrying US government officials, civilian and military personnel and cargo through Shannon Airport. And he went on to say that they liaise with the Irish authorities in relation to flight notifications through and permissions, and they do this through the US Embassy in Dublin, and that they liaise with the Irish authorities and the airport authorities here on technical and logistical issues. Now, we do have to ask, what is it about those US government and government contracted flights that's so special that the very competent staff in Shannon Airport cannot do themselves? What's so different? What's so special about those flights that they need this special assistance from two US officers of military rank? What else have we got? Many of the planes that I mentioned, the Omni Air International troop carrying planes, the Hercules jets, so many of the Kalita Airs, these regularly have security provided for them by the Irish Army and by our Garda Síochána. You will see there the officers of the Irish state and their vehicles sitting under the airplanes or beside the airplanes. In fact, one night I went up to the fence, looked at one of the Omni Air International airplanes, took out my camera, took a photograph, and within approximately 60 seconds there were airport police and Garda Síochána vehicles surrounding me and telling me to leave the airport. We had a lot of to-ing and fro-ing and banter as to what the basis for them asking me to leave the airport was, but the upshot of it all was at that point that they took me right out to the perimeter of the airport beyond the gantry and followed me to ensure that I left the Shannon Air area. So again, we have to ask, what is it about these planes? What was it about the cargo that was being put into the hold of that plane that was so special that it required me and my camera to be taken away so quickly from where I was? We've got, and I think we'll give you all some of the facts and figures as I've quickly outlined them here during the day. As I said, we have an average of 20 flights per week carrying US troops. We have a breakdown of the figures here. So for August, we see that there are 89 commercial airlines carrying US troops or cargo at Shannon. And we go down through all of the months. Incidentally, we've also been logging the commercial airlines that are probably carrying US troops or cargo through Irish airspace that are on US military business. So in August, for example, within approximately 60-mile radius of Shannon, we have recorded 312 commercial airlines on US military business going through Irish airspace. A heck of a lot of traffic that we don't even know about in most cases, and certainly most Irish people don't know about, is passing through our airspace to the unjust and immoral wars that are being carried out in faraway places like Afghanistan and Iraq. So I think I'll leave it at that in terms of the facts and not bore you with too many figures. As Ed mentioned, we continue to monitor, we continue to observe, we continue to record, and we continue to campaign and to protest at the airport. Sunday of every month from 2 to 3 p.m., there is always a group of us here at the airport. We are, I have to say, encouraged by what seems to be a growing support or encouragement for us as we stay there with our banners and placards informing people. There is certainly an unease in this area about what is happening in the airport. Unfortunately, there is insufficient by way of action or by way of questioning or by way of challenging the military activities at the airport. But we're hopeful. As I said, we're going to continue doing this. We're going to be out on the roads. We're going to be here with our cameras continuously. We're going to do our best to shift the opinion to get some of that more information that could take us from the realms of speculation about what really is in these aeroplanes and to bring that to public attention whenever and however we can. So, thank you.